Good Friday afternoon. Well, it's been a very active pattern so far here in the month of March. We've had nor'easter after nor'easter. In fact, as we head into next week, we could be looking forward to our next fourth nor'easter. Yes, that active of a pattern. So a lot of people are asking, well, why are we seeing so many in a row? And is it really rare that we've been seeing so many in a row? Well, you know, not really. We have 2015 to look back at. We have 2010 to look back at, and also 1996, where the same kind of general overall pattern locked into place. And that's exactly what's going on so far over the last couple of weeks. It's something called teleconnections, and that really is just saying that the world's weather is all connected. Something happening on the other side of the world can have an impact on what's going on here on the eastern seaboard. We're going to talk about one particular teleconnection that, when we get this type of scenario, a very pronounced signal comes from it, and it's called the North Atlantic Oscillation, or what we call it, the NAO. And when that goes negative, we see this pattern with nor'easters charging up the eastern seaboard, kind of playing out time after time. We also call that the Greenland blocking high. And it's very hard to break that pattern down once it falls into place. To start talking about that pattern, we need to go very far away from here in Hampton Roads. In fact, we have to go all the way up to Greenland, where that high is sitting in place. We call that the Greenland blocking high. And what this does is it pulls warm air up towards the polar regions. In turn, it shoots down the cold air straight out of Canada, right on into the eastern seaboard, New England area, which is why they call it the nor'easter, you know, zone that gets impacted by those storms. And we see storm after storm, or piece of energy really, kind of riding out of Canada. It dives south along the jet stream, which dips, and then it picks up moisture off the coast. And with that high pressure in place, it kind of ejects it back westwards up to the north and impacts the New England area, and really in turn the mid-Atlantic seaboard, like we've been seeing here. And in fact, as we look at the computer models, it shows another one heading our way. Here's one developing out towards the middle parts of the country this weekend, and by early next week, it does that exact same path, rides up the coastline, and then tracks a little bit back towards the north and west there. Could possibly be bringing more snow to portions of New England and down even as far south as the Washington, D.C. area and northern Virginia. So we'll watch it closely as we get through the upcoming weekend.